In this video, guys, we're going to be going over what you guys can actually expect in the 14.17.21 update. But before we go ahead and get into this video, I would just like to let you guys know that I actually currently am gifting my subscribers. And if you want to go ahead and get any gift from the Fortnite item shop or the new Fortnite Chapter 2 Season 7 Battle Pass, all you got to go ahead and do is make sure you subscribe with all notifications on, and the first couple people to every single video have a chance of getting gifted. So if you want to get a gift from the item shop, just make sure you subscribe with all notifications on. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Aiden, and welcome back to yet another video here on the channel. In today's video, guys, we're going to be going over what you guys can actually expect within the Fortnite 17.21 update. There's four things that we're going to be talking about in this video, and honestly, they shouldn't take that long to explain. So I'll probably be uploading another video later today, so make sure you are turning on all notifications so you don't miss that video. That's going to be a pretty big video that I drop later today as well, and you're not going to want to miss it. But yeah, guys, before we actually go ahead and get into what you guys can actually expect in the Fortnite 17.21 update, make sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe if you are new for even more content just like this one. We've put a ton of Fortnite here on the channel, whether it be Fortnite news, leaks, gameplay, or glitches. So if any of that does sound interesting, you should definitely go ahead and drop a sub as well as subscribe with all notifications on, because guys, if you don't know, I actually currently am gifting my subscribers. And if you guys want to go ahead and get any gift from the Fortnite item shop, that's literally all you have to go ahead and do. Just make sure you are subscribing with all notifications on, and then of course you are coming back for every single video, leaving a like on the video, and then of course commenting down your epic games as well. As long as you go ahead and do that, eventually you will end up getting a gift. Just please be patient with me, guys, because I do have 12,000 subs, so it may take some time for me to actually go ahead and gift you. But as long as you're staying patient with me and you're doing the steps of just subscribing with all notifications on, liking every single video that is new, and then of course coming back for every new video and commenting down your epic games, eventually you will end up getting a gift from me. I literally gifted people in my video yesterday, so make sure to check that out if you don't believe me. And then I have so many other videos on my channel of me just gifting you guys. But yeah, speaking of getting a gift, I'm actually currently hosting a ton of giveaways over on my Twitter, and if you guys want to go ahead and enter in the giveaways, these steps are very, very easy. I think today I'm going to give away the Ninja Bundle, the Gref G Bundle, the Laser Beam Bundle, and maybe the Loser Fruit Bundle and Lockroom Bundle as well, so, you know, stay tuned for that. But in the past, guys, I've actually ended up giving away the Ferrari Bundle, the LeBron James Bundle, and then, of course, I've also given away this little customizable wrap bundle yesterday. And finally, guys, the most recent bundle that I gave away was this Buka bundle right here. If you guys want to go ahead and enter in to get any of these bundles, my Twitter will be linked down in the pinned comment. The steps are in the tweets. As long as you follow those steps, it's pretty easy. All you have to go ahead and do is make sure that you are just liking the tweet of whatever giveaway you actually want to go ahead and enter in, retweeting the tweet, and then of course following my Twitter and commenting down your proof down in the replies to that tweet. But literally, it's a simple as that. I'm going to be giving away more stuff later today, so stay tuned for that. But yeah, now that we have that out of the way, let's go ahead and talk about this 17.21 update. The first thing that we actually have to expect is the August crew pack. Now, obviously, there's a lot of people that are saying the Ariana Grande skin is going to be the August crew pack, and well, I mean, guys, they're just wrong. There's no way they would make an Icon Series skin a crew pack. That just doesn't really make sense for me. If we go ahead and scroll all the way down, here is the current Fortnite crew pack. It is the Loki skin. And well, guys, the next one, I'll go ahead and pop up a picture on screen right now, is actually going to be this skin called Ava. Now, it is encrypted in the files as Buff Cat Fan, and as you could see, it has some sort of tie to Meowskulls, which is very interesting. I don't exactly know why they have it tied to Meowskulls, but I believe this skin was actually a like concept that someone made, and then of course it ended up getting put into the game. And well, it is really cool because this is a pretty nice looking skin. It's definitely not going to be the best crew pack skin that we've ever gotten. However, you know, it's not bad at all. But that is one of the things we can actually expect within the Fortnite 17.21 update. The next thing, which kind of ties into our last one, is the Ariana Grande skin and the concert. Now, as I said, a lot of people are saying that this is going to be the Fortnite crew pack, but we know that's not true. We know that's going to be the Ava skin. However, we have heard a lot about the Ariana Grande concert within Fortnite. Now, I think it's evident from now and and from everything that we've heard, that the console will bring along her skin into the game as well. We've seen a lot of concepts of what this skin can actually look like, and it looks really, really cool. Honestly, I'll be picking up. I don't even really like Ariana Grande. I mean, she's not bad looking, but obviously the skin kind of looks a little weird to me, but I don't know. They kind of, every single time they bring someone that like I see in real life, you know, like someone like LeBron James, or I guess you could even say Ninja or Graf G, it's just, they don't look the same. It's weird. I don't know if the Fortnite style fits them, but maybe that's just me. But yeah, that being said, guys, the concert has been tested by the developers already, and honestly, I think we'll be seeing more of the formation related to the concert become more widespread and available within the Fortnite 17.21 update. The next thing to actually go ahead and mention that will be making its way into the game in the Fortnite 17.21 update is actually the Gravitron weapon. Basically, this gun looks like the gravity gun that we actually saw in the opening cinematic of the Fortnite Chapter 2 Season 7 trailer will finally be making its way into the game within 17.21. It is called the Gravitron, and the gun will actually allow players to pick up and throw objects similar to a saucer's tractor beam, which is actually really cool. Obviously, we saw this within the trailer, and you know, Fortnite Chapter 2 Season 7 has been going on for quite some time now, and it is kind of surprising that we haven't seen it sooner. However, this is a way for them to keep the game fresh and add a brand new weapon for us to actually go ahead and play. So that should be making its way into the game in the 17.21 update. And then of course, the final thing is actually the fancy mothership stuff. Now I say stuff because there's actually a lot of different things actually going on in terms of this like mothership right now. I put a tweet out earlier today showing what the mothership is going to look like in its final form with its event going on. But guess what? There's even more stuff to actually go ahead and talk about with this, I guess, mothership, because it's actually going to be able to create rift zones on the island. Now that to me is kind of weird, but basically I'll go ahead and pop up the tweet by Hypex. He says that Epic are actually planning to bring back the idea of rift zones. The mothership is actually planned to create these zones, probably with a beam. Now the zones are low gravity prop disguise like Season X, but limited to the props in the right pick, so tires, mailboxes, grills, and then of course telescopes as well. And then he says thanks to game shed, prop gun is not limited. And then of course the other areas is rift teleport, and then the final one is actually slide and ice slide, which is really weird. He follows up with that and he says he has no idea where or how these will appear. All I know is that they appear in that order and not all at once. I'll let y'all know later. And he said, remember, this could change due to the 17.21 update next week. However, this will probably be making its way into the game due to the 17.21 update, at least in my opinion. So basically, guys, we're gonna have all sorts of zones from ice slides to prop disguises, and this beam from the mothership will be able to create every single one of them. To be honest, I'm not 100% sure what exactly that's supposed to mean in the first place, and obviously we'll most likely get more details within the Fortnite 17.21 update, or maybe they'll even be making their way into the game for the 17.21 update, which will be very nice as well. However, guys, there honestly isn't going to be anything really major within the Fortnite 17.21 update. It's more of a small update. If you don't know, Fortnite usually does their updates every 2 weeks. So basically, it would be 1 week of an update, no week of an update, another week of an update. I should have said every other week, but you know, this week they're doing 2 updates. So honestly, the majority of that is for the Fortnite crew pack that you guys are seeing on screen right now. And then of course, it's also to bring the new Fortnite crew pack in as well, which is what they usually do. But I mean, there's a high chance that we'll be seeing the Gravitron, these little rift zones created by the mothership beam. And then of course, we will also be seeing the Ariana Grande skin and concert, or at least getting more details on the past 3 items that I just mentioned. But yeah, guys, that actually is where I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up for this video. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like, share, and subscribe. If you are new for even more content just like this one, we upload a ton of Fortnite here in the channel, whether it be Fortnite news, leaks, gameplay, or glitches. So if any of that does sound interesting, you should definitely go ahead and drop a sub as well as subscribe with all notifications on, because guys, if you don't know, I actually currently am gifting my subscribers. And if you guys want to go ahead and get any gift from the Fortnite item shop, that's literally all you have to go ahead and do. Just make sure that you are subscribing with all notifications on, and then of course you're coming back for every single video. At the bare minimum, commenting down your Epic Games, and then of course leaving a like on the video. As long as you go ahead and do that, eventually you will end up getting a gift from me. Just please be patient with me, guys, because it will take some time. Obviously, I can only get the max of 5 people every single day, and I do have 12,000 subs. If I could gift more people, I definitely would, but that is Fortnite's limit. If you guys want to go ahead and make it a little bit easier on me, you could of course add my Epic Games. It actually is BozHub YT. but obviously you don't have to as well. Make sure to enter in all of the giveaways I'm currently hosting on Twitter. I'll most likely tweet out about these icon series skin giveaways real soon, so make sure that you're staying tuned and turning on all notifications for my Twitter. But yeah, with that being said, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.